गौरव, इंट्रोड्यूस योरसेल्फ गौरव।
सर माय नेम इज़ गौरव गुप्ता, आई हेल फ्रॉम जयपुर राजस्थान। आई हैव कंप्लीटेड माय बीटेक फ्रॉम जयपुर इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज एंड रिसर्च सेंटर जयपुर इन 2019। आई एम कंप्यूटर साइंस सेंटर ग्रेजुएट। ड्यूरिंग माय कॉलेज डेज आई हैव डेवलप्ड सेवरल प्रोजेक्ट्स एंड इन द फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर आई हैव अंडरवेंट 2 months ट्रेनिंग एट इसरो सेंटर। वी हैव डेवलप्ड एन एंड्रॉइड मोबाइल एप्लीकेशन नेम्ड एज माय डॉग, where the user gives the symptoms and based on that the application provides the most probable disease. My role in the project was to develop the develop and designs the different modules, and I have also developed a different I have also developed a login module which uses 128-bit SSL encryption. And sir, in my final year I have completed the I presented a survey paper which was later published by Springer Nature. And sir, I've also taken several NPTEL courses where I stood ordinary rank 16 in design and analysis of algorithms and data success course. And sir, after my graduation, I've given the GATE exam where I secured an all India rank of 363. And sir, in 2020, I've also given exam of DRDO GRF of Chandipur, Balasore, and Jodhpur, and also got selected in both of them. And my favorite subjects include operating system, computer networks, design and analysis of algorithm, data structures, and C programming.
Very good profile, Gaurav. So let's start from about who taught you NPTEL in DSA, the professor name.
So the name of professor was Praveen Singh, yes.
From
Praveen
where?
Praveen Singh, from IIT Madras. IIT Madras.
Okay. And data structure?
Sir, it was the same course, data structure and algorithm.
Data structure and algorithm. Okay, good. So you published one paper. What is the title of the paper?
The title of the paper was Performance Impact on Different Parameters by the Continuous Evolution of Distributed Algorithms in Wireless Sensor Networks.
Okay. So, who was the professor with you with this?
Sir, my assistant professor, her name was Himlata Soni, and our principal, Dr. V.K. Chandna.
Okay. So, what does the abstract of your project? Can you tell me the abstract of that paper?
Papers, okay. Sir, actually, the abstract was there have been several parameters which the wireless sensor nodes their performance can be altered. So I have made a survey on that and made a study paper such that this paper will tell all the people who are coming into which are trying to do survey which are trying to research on this that in the survey paper, each and every one will get all the parameters in a tabulated form. And secondly, all the current research that has been conducted and the upcoming events that might be possible to enhance the performance of the wireless sensor networks.
Okay, how did you implement this project?
So this survey paper?
Yes.
So actually, this is just a study paper. I have read several research papers. Then I concluded what all things have been made. I've made several. For example, there have been different protocols. I've analyzed those protocols, and based on that, what were the different parameters used by those particular people? For example, from China, from France, different professors have made those. And I've picked out the common things about them and given in tabulated form so that if anyone wants to have an overview, he can just read this paper and get to know what all has been in the past several years in the field of wireless sensor networks.
Okay, you said you implemented Android application with the 128-bit SSL security, is it?
Yes, sir.
So what is the basically SSL encryption algorithm?
Sir, actually SSL stands secure socket layers. Sir, it is a transport layer security that uses authentication for sake of security. And sir, the size of the key here is 128-bit. The algorithm that is used depends on the according to our need. But basically, in the due course, we use generally RC4 with MD5 security. But if you want to enhance the security, we use the latest algorithm, RSA, along with SHA. But because it is a bit slow, but generally we use RC4.
Okay. So can you tell me what is the bit 128-bit security level, 1024-bit security level? What is this basically?
Sir, can you please repeat the question, please?
What is this 128-bit security level? Somewhere say that 2048 security level. What is this basically? This
sir, 128-bit is the key size, the size of the key which is used to encrypt the particular message. So this tells us the size of the key. There are exactly, sir. It depends. 256-bit is also present. 108-bit is also 1024-bit is also present. 2048 is also present. It depends upon the size, upon the type of program that we want to encrypt. Upon according to a requirement, we use different sizes of keys. The more the size of the key, the more will be the time to encrypt. Hence it will be a time-taking process. Just we generally use a less smaller.
Okay. So tell me, a 128-bit key size is a 128-bit. So if you will generate the number, what is the size of the number will be happen?
Sir, in 128 be a number from that?
Yeah, 128-bit is there, na? So it is a key size, 128-bit. So yes. What will be the size of the maximum size of the number we can generate with the 128-bit?
Simply using 128-bit, what is the maximum size of in binary? It will be only maximum different. Actually, I'm not able to understand the question. If you are saying 128-bit is the size of the key, right? And no. From 128-bit, sir. The number will be of course only 128-bit. There will be 128 different permutations, sir. But the number will be ultimately of 128-bit.
So suppose that you have a bit size of 2-bit, key yes. size of bit 2-bit. How much maximum number we can generate with the 2-bit?
Different numbers, sir.
Yes.
Yeah, 4, sir. 2 power 2.
Yes, so that means here with 128, how much maximum number we can generate?
Sir, the number of different numbers we can generate is 2 power 128.
128 means 2 to the power 128 bit possibility will happen. That's why it's a large size. That's why
I'm asking. Yes,
okay, sir. No issue. So you work in the ISRO as an intern of 2 years and you develop the one application of Android application. You develop yourself or there is a team?
Two months, sir. That was an internship, college internship.
2 months and you developed or team developed?
Sir, there was a team of 4 members, sir.
Four members. What was the work module assigned in Android application?
My role, sir?
Yes.
Sir, my role was to develop first all the different modules of the program, of the Android application. And secondly, I have developed the user interfaces, designed the user interfaces and the login module. The entire login module was developed by me.
Okay. So can you tell me if suppose that I don't know Android application? So, and I know that it's not difficult. So can you tell me that how to state the step by step process?
Okay. So first of all,
Hello World 1.2. I want to develop one application to the Hello World program in the Android page. Okay.
Yes. Sir, simply first of all, there are 2 ways to develop an Android mobile application. We can either develop it using a Java, using language as Java, or using Python language. First of all, if you develop using Java, we have Android Studio for that. And if you want to develop using Python, we have Kiwi language for that. For Kiwi, we can use for Python, we can use the Kiwi. We have to, first of all, we have to download. Now I will start with the Java project, with the Java language. In the Java language, we will first download the Android Studio. It will have the software development kit inside itself. Now we have to choose this type of application we have to develop. The Android Studio itself gives different types of modules to us, which states that do you want a hamburger icon in that? Do you want different modules? The basic module comes up front is the main module. In the main module, we call all other different modules, and with that, in that particular module, we have to write the entire code. along with that, there is a manifest file which states the different permissions that a particular Android app must have. For example, the let's say different permissions that we have, sir. Let's say contact, if you want contacts to be taken from the particular user, or location permissions, or secondly, does the which Android version this application supports, all this is present in the manifest file.
Okay. So you told your favorite subject is computer network, DSA, and C++.
And operating system, sir.
Operating system. Okay. So what is the Baladi effect?
Sorry, sir. What is the
Baladi effect?
Baladi's effect. Yes, sir. So Baladi's anomaly actually states that generally when we increase the number of page frames in a page replacement algorithm, then the number of page faults decreases. But in the case of FIFO, when we try to increase the number of page frames, the page fault increases in some. It has been observed that it increases in some of the page reference strings. This phenomenon is known as Baladi's anomaly.
Okay. So, what is the multitasking and multiprocessing? Difference between the multitasking and multiprocessing.
Yes, sir. Sir, multitasking states that given a single processor, different jobs are provided to the CPU. So that the concept of multitasking says that this processor must always be running a particular program. Thus, it focuses on increasing the CPU utilization, whereas multiprocessing, all the processors, there are multiple processors present, and these multiprocessors are given different jobs, and the basic concept of this is to increase the degree of is to increase the throughput of the system. So the multiprogramming has basis of increasing throughput, whereas multitasking is to increase the CPU utilization, percentage CPU utilization of the system, and decrease the idle time of the system.
Okay. So, Dilip, Gaurav, can you tell me, can one computer can have multiple IP address?
Yes, sir, it can have multiple IP addresses.
Can we work at it at the same time, all IPs in one computer?
No, sir. Not all the all IPs cannot work at the same time. But yes, different IPs can be present, but at that time only one single IP will be active.
What is IP exhaustion? IP exhaustion.
IP exhaustion. Huh. Sorry, sir, I haven't read the name. Oh, can you please tell the name, sir, again? IP?
IP exhaustion. EXHASATION. IP exhaustion.
Yes, IP exhaustion, by the name itself, it implies that the number of IP addresses are getting exhausted. We are running short of these IP addresses, thus we are moving towards IPv6, that is, more number of addresses are being used, because IPv4 has 32 bits only, and these number of bits are limited. Thus we need to expand the IP addresses to in order to give a particular CPU or a particular system a unique IP address.
Okay, what is the size of IPv6?
Sorry, sir, what is the size?
IPv6.
128 bits, sir.
Okay, good. Okay. So, do you when it is generate NAT, network address translation table, network address translation?
The network address translation table is used to is used as a moderator between a private network and a public network. When we convert, when we want to convey a message from a private network to a public network, then the concept of NAT is used. The network address translator converts the private IP into public IP. It uses it assigns a unique public IP. It has single public IP using the port number along with the IP address. It gives each private IP host a unique IP address through which that particular packet can be sent to the outer world.
Okay, one question from the C programming. What is the exact syntax of variable declaration?
Variable declaration.
Yes, variable declaration.
Declaration will be first data type, followed by
name of the variable.
Yes, sir. Identifier.
Identifier. Name of the variable,
and then the semicolon.
Is it exact to syntax?
Maybe not. That's why you are asking.
Okay. What is storage class in the C programming?
Storage classes. Okay, so storage classes are used to provide different parameters, and the are used to give the different parameters of a particular variable. For example, for example, let's say the lifetime scope default value of a particular variable. There are four types of storage classes: register, auto, static, and external.
Okay. So what is the ER diagram, DFD data flow diagram, and C class diagram? What is these three terminology?
First, ER diagram stands for entity relationship diagram. It between two different entities, we draw a diagram to provide what is the connection between the two entities, between the two objects, and it is combined by a single relation, which tells what is the relation between these two entities. And second is DFD data, that is the data flow diagram. It is used to tell the flow of a data in a particular system. It does not define how the control will be flowing, rather it shows how a particular data that is given to the system that will be transferred in a sequence of steps. And the last, sir, can I please tell the last one?
Class diagram.
I'm not very sure about it, but class diagram defines different classes of to which a particular object belongs to. Maybe you're not very sure about that, sir.
Okay. So can you tell me what does NIC basically? What is the work of NIC?
Okay, sir. NIC, that is attached office of Ministry of Electronics Information Technology. It gives the basic or the major e-governance facilities of the Government of India. It along the different, for example, the latest, that is the Arogya Setu app, the Cowin application, all these are developed by NIC. Not only to the center, whereas each state and its districts have a NIC center which provides the informatics distribution across the particular.
Okay, Gaurav. So, what is the full form of NILET?
NIELIT, that is National Institute of Electronics and Information Technology.
Okay, so Gaurav, what was your project in your BTech?
Sir, my project was the same project that we have done in ISRO. I have extended that, and it is the same MyAdoc application, Android mobile application.
Okay, good, no issue. So actually, in panel we have two member currently, but one has to go somehow. I think power cut happened, something happened. So only I am able to take your interview. So I am concluding. If he could have asked some more question to you, but for such unfortunately some situation happened. I think he went. I ping him, but he said some power cut is there. So I am concluding you. So take some point from my side. Your profile is good, and you have a good profile, good intro also, no issue. Only my suggestion is that the intro should be little slow. Like you are speaking very fast, very cool and calm way you speak. It will come by practice, no issue. Okay, you have a time, so no need to worry about that. Whatever the things you are telling, it's very well. The flow is also very good. The flow, the how you tell the all things. Only thing you have to very cool, like you are telling your friend. Nothing else. Yes. That one point you have to keep
actually
in mind.
That because of the interview, the sake of interview, it becomes a bit. And anxiety comes a bit.
Yeah, that's why mock interviews there. So keep it. Your profile is good. You can arrange the things, whatever the things you did, it will be all more better. You can arrange the things sequence way or somehow parallel, sequence wise, like get rank and DRDO and all things. And last, you can tell add the subject, interest subject. Okay. That part is keep it mind. And subject knowledge, you have a good subject knowledge. Only thing is that you have to little more presentable. You are able to speak well. You are able to reply very well, no issues. Only thing is that you have to crisp and information like. No need to speak much. You are speaking very well because you have a deep understanding, so you are able to speak much. So need not to worry. Give the every answer. It should not crisp and precise. Every answer should be not more than 1 minute. You just remember. Don't continuously speak. That's remember. So as much as you will speak less, that's bad and good. And yes, that's enough. You are good. That keep continue your preparation. Keep continue. Hope you will get it. Wish you the best. Siva sir, we can't conclude him. All
okay,
things.
Okay.
Wish you best.
Okay. I could not attend the call. So I had an emergency call. So yeah, please don't mind Gaurav. I think.
It might be possible that I will encounter that question. Because in the previous interview, the first question that was asked about the dangling contra was the first interview question in my ISRO. So there are very much chances that these questions can be coming in the interview. So any question that you can ask, please.
Yeah. So you want me to ask? Yeah. What are your interested subjects?
Sir, networks, operating system, C programming, data structures, and design analysis of algorithm.
Okay. Okay, so in data structures, okay, we have this connected components. Okay, so how you identify those connected components?
Sir, connected components can be identified by using depth first search algorithm. Using depth first search, strongly connected component, weakly connected component can be used. We have to apply the depth first search algorithm twice, and by applying that, we will get to know how many connected components are present in the graph.
Okay. So, so what is the time complexity in adding an element to a max heap?
Adding an element to a max heap, insertion of an element, right, sir?
Yes.
Insertion of an element in a max heap will take big O of log n time, sir.
Log n times. Okay. So can you justify?
Yes, sir. Sir, whenever an element is inserted into a max heap, because it is already a max heap, we insert the element at the very last end. Now we apply heapify algorithm, and we compare that element with the parent. If it is an inversion, invert. Otherwise, we don't invert. So in the worst case, the inversion might take place to the highest level, that is to the root, and thus the height of the tree, the height of the heap is at max, is order of log n. So maximum log n inversion.
Log n base. What is the base?
Sir, log n base.
It is 2.
Okay. Okay, Gaurav. I think I can see your performance is very good. Yeah. So keep it up. Okay, your explanation and technical knowledge is good. Okay.
So keep it, Gaurav. All the best. Yeah, all keep the best. It up. Wish you the best.
All the best.
Thank you very much, sir. Can you share this recording, sir, please?
Yeah, I will share later.
Okay. Okay, sir. I'll give you my mail ID, sir.